hypothetical, working onto something that I'm proud of. Out of the box, an epoxy to the world and the vision we've lost. I'm an apostrophe. I'm just a symbol to remind you that there's more to see. I'm just a product of the system of catastrophe, and yet a masterpiece, and yet I'm half diseased. And when I am deceased, at least I go down to the grave and die happily and leave the body.
Everyone, I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. In today's matchup, we should have a fun one on our hands. It's the Steelers coming in at 7-5, going up against the Ravens, who come in at 9-3.
All right, Larry, EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the steel capital of the world, Pittsburgh, PA, and Heinz Field. This was the scene just a few moments ago as the Pittsburgh faithful were fired up by the hometown Steelers taking the field. They're all set as they'll match up with the Baltimore Ravens. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. Now a carry for the former Michigan State man, Le'Veon Bell. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3. On 2nd down, Roethlisberger. And McDonald here over the middle. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive. Now a 1st down carry by Bell. Runs through the contact. He'll get about 3 as he's brought down right around the 42.
I once had a defensive player in the NFL tell me, if I beat and dominate the guy across from me, I'm helping my team. But winning one-on-one battles is always a part of the game. But when you have good team defense, as we just saw there, one broken tackle, but he didn't get away because the rest of the guys arrived to put him on the ground.
2nd down following the run. They'll go again with Bell, and he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and that'll make it 3rd down.
Every year I go to the combine and marvel at the speeds that linebackers are running nowadays. They run like DBs, and let's face it, they know how to finish plays too. Eyes up, head up, run right through them.
On 3rd down, Roethlisberger. And he's caught on the sideline, but he's not going to have a 1st down. They say he was out of bounds, so a big call there. That brings up 4th. A 3rd down, he tried to stay in bounds, did all he could. He caught it, but was led a little bit too far.
Yeah, and that's always difficult, isn't it? Because you know half of your body is trying to stay behind while the other half is reaching out, trying to catch the football. The top half worked. It was the bottom half that was in question.
It'll be a 44-yard punt, 6 on the return. And the Ravens, they'll take over. Tight, tight. Terrence West. And he'll take this up only to about his 18-yard line. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. Second down, Flacco now. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked up by the former first-rounder, Artie Burns. And that interception sets them up beautifully already in the red zone.
And you can hear it all the way up here. Oski, everyone turned to block, find a spot, and now they're set up inside the red zone for their offense.
Really nice starting field position here for the offensive unit. Roethlisberger with a give to Bell. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Big boys down there in the trenches, and a nice play to stop them cold. Nothing there.
Yeah, when you talk about big boys, you talk about those defensive tackles, those nose tackles. They're not just big, they're immense. And what a big-time play there.
On second down, here's Roethlisberger. This one complete, right side to McDonald. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives them a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
They had great starting position to begin the drive, but now they look up at a third and five. Now Roethlisberger going to hand the Bell. And he goes backwards here, losing yardage back to the 16. It's a loss of a full 3 yards, and it brings up fourth down. Now Chris Boswell for the Steelers' field goal try. This a 33-yard attempt. And Boswell's kick is good. And the Steelers will jump out to a 3-0 lead. So after the pick, they can't capitalize for 6, but they do get 3.
And I know in this situation, most of us want to focus on the offense. You know what side of the ball I played on. Let's give that defense a lot of credit. Taking it over in a sudden change situation and shutting them down.
The return man now is Danny Woodhead. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. Here comes the Raven offense now, ready for another possession. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here, and that'll make this a second and 13. Gun, Flacco. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
This team is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. He came in, made the contact just as he's trying to haul it in.
Thank you. And with a third and 13 here, the defense in a dime look. Time running out here on the play clock. Barely got that snap off. Flacco now. That is caught. It's Perriman. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A very solid gain of 27. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. This is West. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. We haven't seen much from him running the football here in this first quarter.
No, you're right about that. We haven't seen much of him at all so far. They've stacked him up pretty well. But when you're trying to run the football, sometimes you've got to play the long game. Keep handing it to him, and some of those runs that aren't working now, they turn into 6, 7, 8, and maybe more later on.
On the ground, it's West again. And he's brought down. 10 yards there, good enough for a Raven first down.
Partner, I think a lot of people thought that Baltimore would draft at least one runner. In fact, they didn't take any skill position players in the draft, so I think a lot's still going to fall on Terrence West.
Well, he did have over 1,000 yards from scrimmage last year, a career high. A first carry now for Alex Collins. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down, and as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
See if they stay on the ground for second down. A break from the ground game here, Flacco. And this is caught, Jeremy Maclin. And they do get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. A good pickup there, 26 yards. Second quarter now, Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis with you. It's the Ravens who have the football, and they've got it here with a first down. And the defense with their backs against the wall a little bit here as the offense is in the red zone. They come out here in the eye. They'll try to pound it in with West. And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the 5. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Partner, you mind if I take off this headset and put on a coaching headset?
You want to get this running game going?
I want to get this running game going. I'm going down there and saying, gentlemen, we have got to run the football. We've got to get it going right now.
Yeah, to this point in the second quarter, it has been a struggle. Won't come so easy as they'll in fact tackle him behind the line. He'll wind up losing 3, and now it's third down. They've been stuffed twice here for losses. Now it's third and goal. Flacco. But they'll say it's incomplete.
Well, it's been a tough go for them. These guys have been driving down the field, but defensively, once they got their backs to the goal line, turned up the pressure, that's going to lead to a fourth down. Well played.
So on fourth down, Flacco off to the sidelines. He gives way to Justin Tucker from the right hash, and this one just a chippy. And Tucker's kick right there, it's good, and that will tie us at 3-3. And that field goal caps an 11-play drive.
That's a lot of offense to run to only get 3 points, but they'll take them. Anytime you can put anything on the board, you run to your sideline somewhat happy.
So a very short kick here. This will be taken by one of the upmen. And they're going to have really good starting field position here as that's taken up close to the 40. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And last time able to get three. It's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just, I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six. They'll throw on first down with Roethlisberger. He sets to fire deep. Got a man, it's caught at the 6-yard line. It's a big play, Roethlisberger to Brown. 58 yards. A great job pulling that one in from a guy, as we know, who can really blaze. He's got a lot of speed.
And that speed can work for him so many different ways. Sometimes he just takes off and goes and just runs past people. Sometimes you get people to back off so far that you can catch everything underneath. But still, at some point in the game, you probably have to make some contested catches, right? Sometimes you have to go up and beat a defender for the football. He has that in his arsenal as well.
Showed it right there. They'll try and run it in with Bell. No gain there, and it's going to set up second and goal.
Okay, no score on that play, but this guy's been a touchdown machine all year long. You know they trust him with the football.
They'll try again with Bell. And I think they stopped him again. They did at the 1-yard line. Call it no gain that time, and now it's third and goal.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
A big play to start the drive got him in this position, but this defense has held firm since, and now it's third and goal. Here's Bell, and he's in. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Le'Veon Bell, touchdown number 18 on the year. And the Steelers are able to strike for six. Able to punch it in on third down makes it easier for those guys on the sideline. They didn't have a fourth down decision to make.
Yeah, could you feel the exhale? Because they were already thinking ahead, as all the good coaching staffs do. Anticipating, will we have to make the call? They already had it lined up, never even got to it.
Boswell on now to kick this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Ravens offense now, they get set and head back onto the field. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points?
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Bash.
Super toe.
Oh, look over the middle, and he's got Perriman. And they're able to get this one across the 35. That one good for 13 and a Raven first down.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-arm guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
Here's Flacco. He's got the veteran here. It's Mike Wallace. And he is hit pretty hard from the side as he's knocked down. The Raven passing game getting in sync. Another first down. Clock running, under four to play now as they come up on first and 10. And he's going to be met at about the 43. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far. And after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. Down at about the 42. He'll pick up only a yard there, and it'll leave him with a 3rd and 7.
Well, they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you've got to continue to try and run and try and keep the defense honest.
You mean, or else they'll just sit back, dare you to throw it on every down?
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
So now at 3rd and 7, and defensively, it's a dime look. 6 DBs. Now Flacco. And the 3rd down pass falls incomplete.
And it is true. You can draft the fastest. You can draft the most athletic guys. But if they don't know the art of positioning, sometimes it's all for naught. In this case, in the right spot, help force the incompletion.
Yeah, but had his hands on it for a second. Would have been a tough catch, though. Falls incomplete. So on 4th down, here's Sam Cook to punt it away. Back deep for the Steelers, Antonio Brown. And the win last week, punted 4 times as this one's away. And a big collision there as he winds up flat on his back. Well, not good at all. A punt of just 24 yards there. And the Steelers will go on offense here, 1st and 10. The drive with a carry by Bell, and an alley to run, and he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. That good for 19 and a 1st down. Two minutes to play here in the 1st half. Back to Heinz Field after this. Throwing now, Roethlisberger on 1st down. Over the middle here to Brown. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. It's a Pittsburgh 1st down, a gain of 13. The give is to Bell. And he's got it across midfield and down to about the 47-yard line. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3.
Getting had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. Fake to Bell. Now it's Roethlisberger. Eluding the pressure right. And too much juice. It'll be out of bounds, incomplete. Trying to get it there to Martavis Bryant. And it's 3rd and short.
Even though that one was incomplete, you could see the training that went into that play. He gets out of the pocket, ends up moving to his right. All he's trying to do, though, extend the life of the play. Keep it alive, hoping someone would pop free.
Was able to take a pretty good shot with a deep ball, but incomplete. And the Steelers on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 3. Out of the gun, it's Roethlisberger. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up 4th down.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this 3rd down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they were unsuccessful.
Here's Jordan Berry now, as he'll kick it away for the 2nd time. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. And this is going to carry well into the end zone for a touchback. Now the Baltimore offense heading back out onto the field. The last couple of drives have ended in punts. Maybe the crowd minds that, but you're a defensive guy. You're okay with a couple of punt drives.
Listen, I'm the guy that loves a 0-0 pitch game. All right, in baseball, I can handle that going into the 7th inning. I think the crowd, though, they want to see a little bit more excitement. Let's see if someone can break something free on offense.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off, it's the Pro Bowl corner, Joe Hayden with it.
Well, this had trouble written all over from the start. He's got 2 extra defensive backs in the game he's got to deal with. They're in a dime set. So everywhere he's looking, he's seeing a different color jersey. And sure enough, this one winds up being intercepted.
And they'll start this drive with very good field position. On 1st and 10, it's Roethlisberger. A screen to Bell. And they're going to lose some on this play. Being knocked back to the 18. That'll wind up going for a loss of 4. And it'll bring up a 2nd and 14. From the gun, it's Roethlisberger. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by the longtime Charger, Eric Weddle.
Brandon, this is why golfers do their best to never count a score in their head before the ball goes in the cup. This looked like a slam dunk for points on this drive, didn't it? Instead, they throw an interception, and they're going to come away empty.
They get the pick. Now what can Flacco do on 1st down? And the Steeler pressure too much here. He's going down. Cameron Hayward in there to sack him for a loss of 6. On 2nd down, Flacco to throw. And he finds a man on the crossing route. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. Fresh set of downs here. Flacco from the gun. He's got his man on the crossing route. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the 1st half. And you see the clock almost empty, so this is likely the last play in the 2nd quarter. Barring the flag. Final play here for Flacco and company. And he's going to go down. Couldn't get a throw off with the pressure. Maybe that was for the best, as that brings us to the end of his first half of play. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Out come the Ravens now. They'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess that in the locker room, they talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there, just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up. We still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that'll bring up a second and 11. Play clock winding down. Flacco here on second down. Under pressure, and Flacco's gonna be dropped.
The game plan for any defense is finding ways to make a quarterback uncomfortable in the pocket. When you bring pressure from all angles, you never know who's going to get home. In this case, the left cornerback, right in the face of him, puts him down.
Flacco and the Ravens now, after the sack, need something good here on third and long. Operating out of the gun, Flacco. And he's got his man, that's Macklin. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. A good pickup there, a 22. He's such a good route runner, shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down.
On first down, Flacco looking deep here for Macklin. So they took a shot on first down but couldn't connect. A pretty good coverage there in both of these defenses. They've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it. And in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
Second and 10. Flacco once more. He almost had it. The big D lineman nearly had an interception. Instead, it falls down incomplete.
He's got to be kicking himself right there. His team's already picked off two passes. That would have been the third in the game. And boy, they've really played well attacking the football.
The Ravens on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is third and 10. Setting up to throw, Flacco. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked up by the former first-rounder, Artie Burns. And the return stops at the 39-yard line. Well, that's three picks he's now thrown in this game.
And I know this, the holiday season, because here we are in December.
Season of giving.
Right, it is the season of giving. Maybe for his own sake, after the game, he may have to announce that he's donating certain amounts to charity for each interception that he threw.
After the interception, here's Roethlisberger. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. That goes for a gain of 31. The last drive, he threw the pick, but he's not shy. He's going downfield again there.
And you can't be, because if you back off after throwing an interception, your whole game plan just goes right out the window, and it makes things easier for a defense. And you and I both know there's no quarterback in this league that's any good that doesn't throw an interception occasionally, and they usually bounce back in a big way. I've seen guys throw five and still find a way to win the game in the end.
They go play action here on first down. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's the one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
Second down following the incompletion. From the shotgun, it's Roethlisberger. Escaping the pressure right. And he'll just throw this one over in the way of the security crew. Incomplete here.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
The offense on third down, they've only converted once in four tries. This is third and goal. And they'll give it to Bell off tackle. Give him 4 yards there, but they're still well short of the goal line with fourth down now looming.
This is where you're probably weighing the score and the clock. Third quarter, so maybe it's a little early to start worrying about how much time is left in the game. But if you kick the field goal, you make it a two-score game. A tough balance and a tough decision for any coach to make.
And Boswell's kick is good. And they will stretch their lead to 10 now at 13-3. So put another three on the board. And all things considered, a good opening drive here to begin the third quarter.
It sure was. I think as a head coach, you're happy to come out and put a little drive together, take the 3 points, and build on your lead.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. And now here come the Ravens. Shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. He hits his target, left side, Watson. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. Second down now after the pass completion. From the gun, Flacco. Over the middle and into the hands of his receiver, Macklin. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. They get 14 on that one. That's good for a Baltimore first down. So here we go, first and 10 now. Now Flacco. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. James Harrison in there to get him. And that's sack number 6 for him on the year. Second down, Flacco now. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Watson. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. He's been quiet today in the passing game, just his second catch.
Yeah, and people have to come up with schemes to limit him. And what a lot of teams do, they'll double him, you know, use a linebacker underneath, a safety over the top. Sometimes they'll just take a corner, maybe their third corner if he's a bigger guy, and put him on a man-to-man to try and limit his touches. Just keep mixing it up, give him different angles, different looks, like a good boxer does. And we're into the second half now, and this is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know, the rhythm seems off. Here's Sam Cook now. as he'll punt it away for the second time. And now a high kick trying to pin him back. And it's picked up by the Ravens.
I feel like you and I could be in our backyard with our dads right now. What did they always say when they were throwing us the ball? Look it all the way in. Make sure you secure it. That had the feeling of not happening there on that play, that he didn't have full control of the ball.
When that punt's coming in, I've never returned punts, but I would imagine it's tough to monitor those guys coming full steam ahead at you.
It really is. You try and get that peek to know where they are, about whether you should fair catch it or not. But sometimes you just have to have a sense, a feeling, and just have to make sure, number one, though, you catch the ball and put it away.
Here's a first down run with Collins. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. They'll run it with West. And he's going to be met at about the 43. He only got a couple on that one, so not a ton of help. They'll have a 3rd and 8 forthcoming.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
3rd down, Flacco needs a decent chunk of yardage. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
That's a 1st down if he holds on, but you saw the contact, able to jar it free from him and force a 4th down.
Great play defensively there, as you said, just to knock it free, because if he had caught that, pass the sticks, 1st down. Here's Sam Cook now, as he's on to punt for Baltimore. And he'll get this away into the icy winner air. And they will get to this one and down it at the 13-yard line. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
On 1st down, it's Roethlisberger. He'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he'll go down after losing yardage at the 10. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's 2nd down. 2nd down and a little ways to go here. 2nd and 13. Now it's Roethlisberger. Flush to his right. Man open right side, it's Rodgers. A good pick up there of 20 yards.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a 1st down.
So the offense has it 1st and 10. Give to Bell, and able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line. And give him 4 yards there. It'll be 2nd and 6. Now, I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
On second down, it's Bell. And after the good game last play, this time they say, as he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down. And before they can run this third down play, we're going to get a timeout. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. And the Steelers on third down, just 1 for 5 to this point. This is third and 9. Roethlisberger. And a big loss here as he's taken down. And when you go 5 wide like they just did there, you can't really max protect, can you?
No, you cannot. What you're hoping is that by going 5 wide, you're forcing the defense into coverage. And if you do that, you get a chance to find some people downfield. But if they audible themselves and go into a blitz, then it's got to happen right now.
Or very lights quickly, out.
Or exactly right. Turn them out. That play's over.
They'll call it a punt of 44 yards. The return was for 7. And possession will switch hands, 1st and 10. Down Flacco, a look over the middle, and he's got Perriman, and he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40. A good pickup there, a 22. Offense comes to the line now, 1st and 10. Flacco to the right side, and he's got Macklin complete. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
Second down, they need less than a yard to pick up the first. Shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks. Now the offense lining up, 1st and 10. Flacco will take to the air again. A swing pass caught, and he doesn't quite make it. They do stop him, but he gets it all the way down to the 1. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. Toss. This is West. And he will take it in for a Ravens touchdown. Terrence West hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Ravens draw a bit closer. And he puts it through there within 3. It's 13 to 10. Here's Tucker now out to kick this one away. This one fielded at the 5. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. The Steelers' offense now, they head back onto the field. Certainly want to avoid what they had to do last possession, and that was pump the football, because this game's starting to tighten up.
In a basketball sense, you think about taking a little bit of the air out of the ball, right? Maybe milk some clock, limit the possessions. In this case, they might want to do the same thing, but control the game offensively. Put together some first downs, put together a drive, and keep it away from them.
Well, we had a number of good games in the afternoon sessions, but this Sunday nighter might top them all. So we come up here on 1st and 10. Out of the gun, it's Roethlisberger. Out to the flat, that's complete to his running back. No gain, and it's 2nd down. Now, they couldn't get anything going there out on the right side of the flat of the swing pass.
And didn't we have a discussion with their staff about wanting to get the backs more involved in the
big
passing
emphasis.
Game? Huge emphasis for this game, but obviously the defense had other plans and really made a nice play.
Offense looking to avoid a 3rd and long. It's 2nd and 10. Out of the pistol, it's Bell. He works his way forward for a couple up past the 30. This defense starting to buckle down when they need to, and right now they're winning this fourth quarter, losing the game, but they're winning in the fourth quarter.
And what a fine line it is about what they're trying to get done, because they're down, so they obviously need the football, need a score, but they can't be so aggressive as to give up their edge, their gaps, and have the offense hit them with a big play.
One of the bigger plays in the game thus far, and the crowd getting into it as we come up on a big 3rd down. Now it's Roethlisberger. Now look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by Tony Jefferson. And they'll start with great field position at the 41-yard line. They get the pick. Now what can Flacco do on 1st down? And this is caught. Jeremy Maclin. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. Time starting to run out here in the 4th. This defense just trying to keep the offense off the board and preserve this potential victory. Flacco here on 2nd down. And he's got the hook up to Maclin. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs. Fourth quarter, 2-minute warning about to hit, and it looks like they're going to get one more play in.
Be interesting to see what they try and do on this play. Do they try and take a shot, or do they just try and get to the 2-minute warning?
Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this. To throw on 1st and 10 with Flacco. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up 2nd down.
It's a lot of contact going on there. And in the end, unable to keep 2 hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. 2nd down and 10. He'll look to throw. Going back to Maclin. This time he's got it. Complete. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. The Raven passing game getting in sync, another first down. And now all of a sudden, the shoe's kind of on the other foot. Maybe you pull the reins back here a bit?
Yeah, a little bit, because you got to make sure that you don't score too quickly.
And from the 9-yard line now, it's first and goal. They'll run the counter with Collins. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. He'll get 2 out of that run, and it's going to bring up a 2nd and goal. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
Second and goal from the 7. And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up 3rd. He already has 2 sacks to his credit. Now another tackle for loss.
And you know how you can always identify who was supposed to block him? They're the ones helping up the person who just got knocked to the ground with the ball, right? Whether it's a running play or a pass play, they've got to figure out a way to slow him down. Maybe you chip him with a 2nd guy. Maybe you just out and out double him. Maybe you make sure you take the ball and throw it as far away from him as possible. Because right now, he is wrecking things for them.
And this offense on 3rd down today, lacking much success, just 2 for 7 to this point. They're looking at a 3rd and goal here. He's back to throw. His pass caught at the 4. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. A 4-yard pickup, not enough. 4th down. They still got 2 timeouts. Got to start using them, don't they?
You absolutely have to. You save them for this situation, but you have to use them.
So on 4th down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. Now a final chance to stop it here as a timeout comes in with 10 seconds left in the game. So on 4th down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This to potentially send us to overtime. And his kick is right there. It's good. And they will tie this game here in the final seconds. So a money kick there in the final seconds, and now, barring any hijinks on the kickoff here, partner, I think you and I, we're going to settle in for a little overtime.
And I wouldn't have it any other way. This has been a dogfight all through regulation. No reason to think it won't continue in the extra period.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Steelers offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. They have a little bit of time here to get into field goal range, not much. In a tie game, you don't want to do anything crazy, right?
I agree with you on that one. Risk reward, okay? If you go for it, what is the absolute reward on this? But the risk is probably greater. Run the clock out, get to overtime, and try and win it there.
All right, we'll see if they do just that. Throwing now is Roethlisberger. He's going deep for Brown. And this one is incomplete. And here in overtime, if the team that receives the ball scores a touchdown, it's over. If they don't, we can still have some more football.
That's exactly right. If they go down and kick a field goal, the other team gets a possession to either match it or score a touchdown to win the ball game. If both teams kick field goals, the next team to score wins. But if the receiving team throws a pick 6 or fumbles the ball and it gets picked up by the defense and they score, the game is over at that point.
So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Steelers offense now, they head back onto the field. They control their own destiny here. They have the football in overtime. Obviously, a touchdown would win it.
And I think teams around the league are still adjusting to the idea of going downfield, scoring a touchdown wins the game, because they were used to just going downfield and trying to get in field goal range to win a game. Still having to make that transition, let's face it now, the ones who are doing it best know they need to go down, attack, put the ball in the end zone, and not leave it up to a field goal and give the other team a chance.
As we said, they control their own destiny now. They'll start out on the ground with Bell. Try to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. So nothing there. I don't know that that's all in the back, though. You got to look at blocking there, don't you?
I would agree with that totally. At some point, they have to win at the point of attack. Instead, it was the defense getting it done again and holding them to no gain.
So second and 10 here. And now the Ravens are going to take another timeout. They'll be down to just one remaining as we step aside here in overtime. Ten yards still left on second down.
Watch 89. Watch 89.
Here we go.
First throw in overtime now for Roethlisberger. Flushed out right. And a big loss here as he's taken down.
Well, we knew this guy wasn't especially fleet of foot, but he tried to conjure up some escapability, but there was no way he was getting away on that one.
So the sack, and now a third and long situation for the Steelers and Ben Roethlisberger. From the shotgun, it's Roethlisberger. And he's going to go down right near the goal line. The officials look at each other. They're going to mark him at the one-yard line.
I think most quarterbacks would love to have the goal line actually extend up into the air and turn into a wall. They could put their back against it and know exactly where they are on the field so they don't end up in the end zone. Didn't do it on that play, but perilously close to the goal line.
And he's able to get it out quickly, and this is not a bad kick here. Campanaro on the return. 12 yards on the return that time. And the Ravens set up well to begin their drive as it'll begin in enemy territory already. The Ravens offense now, they get set to head back on the field. Their defense did its job, got the stop. All they need is three, and this is over.
Couldn't have done much else other than score themselves and end it. But they turned it back over to them, and now all they need is a field goal to win the game. An excellent job by the defense. Can the offense finish things off?
Yeah, part one is done, now part two. Now they try the right side here. Room here to run. And he's going to get this inside the 30. That's good for a Raven first down, 15 yards there.
And that's something that's been lacking in Baltimore's running game the last few seasons, the ability to really hit on a big run.
Last year, their longest run was just 41 yards all season, 4 yards per carry near the bottom of the league. So the run gets them the first, and now they operate with a fresh set of downs. Now a handoff here to his running back. Down to the 25. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9. And that carry probably not so much for yardage, just to get the spot that you want to kick the field goal.
And any yardage you gain there is really kind of gravy, and this just becomes what my old coach used to say. Get into position to be in position. And that's what they want, the right spot for their kicker to line up the field goal.
Second down following the run. On the toss, there goes West. And some room to maneuver. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. That one good for 17 yards, and now they've got it first and goal.
Well, how many times do we say in this game that speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways? In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty. Can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary. That led to a really nice game.
And he's going to ball his way down to about the 1 yard line. It's a good pickup of 7 yards, and now they're looking at second and goal. 2 minutes to go here in overtime. We'll be back after this. They come out with one back and three tight ends. Trying to punch it in with Collins. And he is not going to get in as the big bodies stop him at the one. They hold him again, and now all of a sudden it's third and goal at the one. This offense so far on third down, they've struggled to the tune of 2 for 8 so far. This is third and goal. Now they'll run it on the toss. And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. Only a yard that time, so now a decision to be made here on fourth and goal. And I know you, with every carry, especially in overtime, you're just saying, if you're that ball carrier, hold on to the football.
Hold on to it, protect it, but not necessarily settling, because you're trying to get to the end zone. You're trying to end the game right here. And I know the defensive guys, poking, clawing, raking, trying to knock the ball free and protect their end zone.
Yeah, like you alluded to, especially this part of the field. And he got it. The kick is good in overtime. He's able to split the uprights. We thought this game would be a good one. It did not disappoint into overtime, and it took the field goal to win it.
And we always pay lip service to how important it is to play defense. And usually we focus on the big offensive pyrotechnics, right? But in this case, they got the ball back on defense, gave themselves a chance, and they capitalized on it with a victory.
And I don't care what distance that field goal's from in overtime. The knees are always knocking, but he pushed it through.
Not only that, think about your snap.